Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. In the series of Goods and Services Tax, we are going to take another important topic that is known as the Input Tax Credit. It is very important, as you all know, that taxing system of GST is all about input and output. So, more a government is going to get the revenue in the form of GST, more development can be done and more economic growth can be achieved. In the first lecture, I have told you about the introduction of GST as well as the aims and relevance of GST. In this topic, we are going to discuss about the input tax credit. So, let's explore and find that what is input tax credit. So, input tax credit is a key feature of the goods and service tax system. It allows business to claim a credit for the taxes paid on inputs, that is known as goods or services, used in the production or supply of taxable goods or services. So, as you all know that GST is being levied on the goods or the services which is being provided. So, when we talk about the goods, you are going to manufacture a good, and this manufacturing of a good requires raw material, production units and the finished good to be given in the market. So, you require logistics, supply chain management, everything is being properly discussed whenever we are going to make the GST implemented for any country. So, when the government of our country introduced GST, it has taken into consideration all these things, that raw material, finished good, logistics, supply chain management, and after that a proper model is being set up and is being implemented. So here, input tax credit is a key feature which is being implemented in our Goods and Service Act. So in this act, whenever a product is being produced and is being supplied to the market or a service is being given, a tax is being levied, and that tax should have a proper mechanism. So, that mechanism is known as input tax credit. How ITC works? It is very important because as a student, we don't know that how it is being implemented. So, to know it, let's understand step by step. First, whenever we are talking about a good, you have to say a business purchases inputs, goods or services for its operation. So, whenever you are doing any business, you are doing a business by the help of any product, you are making a product or you are producing a product or you are providing services. So, the first step over here is this, that whatever operations you are doing, you must consider that operation for your input tax credit. In the second step, the supplier charges GST on the inputs. Means supplier, a person who is giving you the product. Whenever you are producing a product, you require raw material. So, from the place you are buying a raw material is your supplier. So, whenever you are going to order a product or the raw material, the person who is supplying has to pay a GST at a specific registered slab in which his product is being kept. If it is being kept in the area of 5% zone, he has to pay 5%. If 18%, he has to pay 18%. If 12%, he has to pay 12%. If 28%, he has to pay 28%. So, according to the zone at which his product, his raw material comes, he has to pay the tax. And then that specific thing is being delivered or supplied to the person who is going to produce or who is going to process that raw material. The business pays the GST amount to the supplier. Means here the supplier used to charge and the person who is buying is going to pay the GST to the person who is availing the activity. The business can claim a credit for the GST paid on inputs
against its own GST liability. As when a person has bought the raw material, has paid the GST, so this tax is being credited and is a liability from a person who has bought the things. So this liability is being reduced when that person is selling his product to further supply chain. And that if a raw material is being bought at rupees 100 and he is giving 18 rupees at tax, so automatically that is being less when a person is selling his product to the future person. Input tax credit can be used to reduce the business GST liability or claim a refund. So automatically when the product, final product comes into action, the liability is being reduced and the person or the firm who is making the final product and has paid the GST in the raw material can claim that and get refund when the product is being processed in the market. Now, by the help of an example, we can understand that how it works. A manufacturer purchases raw material worth rupees 100 with 18% GST. For example, person A is here. So, person A is used to provide raw material to person B, and the cost of this raw material is 100 rupees. So here on the raw material, this raw material comes at a slab of 15%. As you all know, you have got 15%, 12%, 28% slab. So in the example, this comes into 18% slab. So he has to give 18% of 100 rupees, that is 118 rupees. So whatever raw material B is going to buy from A, if the cost of that raw material is 100 rupees, he has to pay GST of 18% and the final product he is buying, that is raw material, is 118 rupees. Now, he is going to process that raw material and make it, convert it into the final product. The manufacturer can claim rupees 18 as input tax credit. Means now B has converted, if you say raw material into finished good. B has converted into finished good and sell this finished good to C. And hope, let's say that in converting this raw material into finished good, the cost which he has to pay, the overall cost of manufacturing is 100 rupees. So 118 he has paid, 100 rupees is the cost, so 218 rupees is somewhere he has got the cost price of that product. Now, whenever he is going to product or deliver this product to C, this 18 rupees which he has paid over here is going to be minus from the product. As soon as he is going to give over here, he can levy another 18% tax and the first tax which he has paid is being reduced. His claim is being reduced and he will get a 18 rupees reduction in this final product and 200 rupees will be the cost. If the manufacturer GST liability is rupees 50, then the cost used will be 18 ICT to reduce their liability to 32 rupees. Means, for example, if you say that after the product, the MRP of that product is 500 rupees and it comes into 5% whatever product he has made. So it has got a GST liability of 25 rupees. He has paid 18 rupees. Now, in his product, he has to pay 7 rupees as 18 rupees has been reduced over here. In the same manner, if the slab changes into 18%, he has to pay 18% of the 500 rupees, and on that rupees 18 will be minused as he has got the claim. So whatever liability he has got, if he has got a liability of 50 rupees, 18 rupees will be subtracted and he has to pay 32 rupees. If he has got a liability of 100 rupees, 18 rupees will be subtracted and he has to pay 72 rupees. So you must have to understand that by the help of a system mechanism, input tax credit, you have to reduce the tax liability, the amount you have paid in the GST. Now, what is the benefits of input tax credit? Reduce tax burden. As I have explained you by the help of an example, so whatever tax a person is paying on his goods and services, that tax is a liability for that business and he can take or claim refund for that tax which he has paid. Increases cash flow. As you all know that as soon as the liability comes, a person who is providing the goods or services has to pay the tax. So that tax which is being claimed over there is being paid by a person who is providing the services or good in an online medium. So there is a proper flow of money. The money is not stagnant over here. It is not being stopped. Automatically, when the product is being finalized and again it is being processed, new tax comes over here and the less liability is being reduced and that is being refunded to the person, previous person who has got the things. Encourages compliances. More you have got the section system, the more compliance is being there, evasion is being reduced, and by the help of input tax credit, as the person knows that as soon as the product or services is provided in the market, he is going to get the refund of its tax. Simplifies tax administration, as here in each and every step, a person knows that by paying the GST, we are going to save our money, as we are helping the nation, we are contributing the development of the nation, as well as we are reducing our tax liability by the amount in which we are paying the tax. Now, let's see that in what are the areas in which input tax credit is available, because in some areas it is not available. So, first let's explore in what areas it is being available. Input tax credit is being used in all the taxable supplies, means all the product which is being kept in a zone of taxable items are being considered over here, and are only being considered over here the products which is being kept in the taxable zone. Capital goods with some exceptions are also being considered over here. And the third is input services used in taxable supplies, means whatever taxable supplies you are going to do, it is being available. So input tax credit is only being implemented when you have got taxable supplies, capital goods, and you have got the taxable uses. So for these three things, you have got input tax credit available. Now, when input tax credit is not available, so when we have got exempt supplies, certain input items which is being exempted from the government of the India to be not considered in the taxing system, that is being not kept over here. Then personal use or consumptions, whatever you are going to take or buy for your personal use or consumption, you are not going to pay input tax credit system. So all the items which is being used personally is not being considered over here. Input used for making non-taxable supplies. So whatever inputs you are making and you are making for non-taxable supplies, it cannot be considered because it follows a specific chain. So, when you are making anything for your personal consumption or you are making anything which has been non-taxable, your input tax rate system not works over here. So, input credit, tax credit is very important, as you will see that it works in a specific chain. All the chain rests with the people previous to our point, and this must be considered that all the taxing which is being paid by a person, all the tax which is being levied on a business or an individual for providing services is going to be refunded when a person is providing goods or service to the future person. So, this is a chain which is being kept into mind. And whatever liability is being there, it is going to be refunded by the help of input tax credit. So, somewhere the other, input tax credit is a very good mechanism by which we get transparency and accountability in the goods and service tax. It is one of the best tool, and it is a system by which we can say that it provides transparency and a proper management of GST. I hope you have understood. Thank you.